Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss about the wireless technology that we use to provide the wireless connectivity over the internet. Now, as you can see, wireless technologies differ in variety of dimensions, most notably in how much bandwidth they provide and how far apart communicating nodes can be. So obviously, according to the need of the hour, we can define various wireless technologies. So in different wireless technologies, we use Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, more formally known as 802.11, WiMAX 802.16, and basically 3G, 4G, and 5G that is still have to be used in India. Now, the most widely used wireless links today are usually asymmetric, means there is one server and multiple number of nodes that are connected with each other. So we call that particular central station as a base station. So base station must be a wired connection to the internet or other networks. And a client node is often mobile, which can move, and it relies on its link to the base station or central stations for all its communication with other nodes. The wireless communication naturally supports point to multipoint communication, means there is one point called base station and multiple number of client stations are connected with the base station. And we use basically radio waves for wireless communication because radio waves sent by one device can be simultaneously received by many devices. Now, the most prominent technique that we want to discuss here is Wi-Fi, and the standard given by IEEE is 802.11. So Wi-Fi is technically a trademark owned by a trade group called the Wi-Fi Alliance that certifies product compliance with 802.11. Now, IEEE has defined the specification for its wireless LAN known as 802.11, which covers the physical and data link layer. So this wireless Wi-Fi, wireless fidelity, basically known as wireless fidelity, it covers physical and data link layers and its various features. 802.11 is designed for use in limited geographical area. Basically, it can be used within home, within office buildings, and within campus. And its primary challenge is to mediate access to a shared communication medium in this case. The physical properties of 802.11. So, the original 802.11 standard defined two radio based physical layer standards. One using frequency hopping and the other using direct sequence. So, we basically use FHSS frequency hopping spread spectrum and direct sequence spread spectrum DSSS. Both provide up to 2 Mbps. The physical layer standard 802.11b was added by IEEE using 2.4 GHz frequency band. So the frequency bandwidth that is used by 802.11 is a 2.4 GHz frequency. Then we come to the 802.11a standard, which delivers up to 54 Mbps using a variety of frequency division multiplexing called orthogonal frequency division multiplexing, OFDM. So here we will not discuss about OFDM. We basically discuss about 802.11. So there are standards 802.11a, which provides 54 Mbps speed, 802.11b, which use 2 GHz frequency band, and 802.11g, which is backward compatible with 802.11b. Now, the architecture totally relies on the infrastructure like this. So here we can see this particular is the infrastructure in which an access point is there, and all the other stations or all the other nodes are connected with this access point. And here, this is without any infrastructure. So here no access point is available. All the stations are connected directly with each other. So this kind of network is known as ad hoc network in terminology of computer network. And this kind of technique, this kind of architecture is known as infrastructure network. So what do you mean by infrastructure network? So an infrastructure network is basically a BSS, basic service set, that are connected with access point. Access point is a central, is working like a server, central station. And the ad hoc architecture supports the stations connected with each other. So this one, the left side of your screen, the network is known as ad hoc network, and the other network is known as infrastructure network. Okay, the architecture depends upon the three things. First one is access point, which is an optional central base station which provides the facilities to individual stations or clients. Then we have basic service set, which is a building block of wireless LAN. So BSS are nothing but they are the collection of the stations along with access points. And when we are connecting multiple number of basic service sets, then we call it as ESS, extended service set. So we can either use ad hoc networks or we can use infrastructure network. Extended service set is nothing but it is made up of two or more basic service sets with access points. So when we connect multiple number of basic service sets along with access points, we create an extended service set. In this case, the BSSs are connected through a distribution system which is usually a wired LAN. So while creating an infrastructure network for wireless LAN, we connect BSSs or basic service sets through a distribution system. This distribution system connects the access points in basic service sets. The services of access points are given by distribution systems, which is a wired LAN. IEEE 802.11 does not restrict the distribution system. It can be any IEEE LAN such as an Ethernet. So obviously there is a distribution system which we can use here for providing the service to wireless LAN. So this may be an Ethernet 802.3 that we have discussed earlier. Also, extended service sets may be either mobile or stationary types. The mobile stations are normally stations inside of BSS, and the stationary stations are access point stations that are part of wired LAN. So ESS can be either mobile or stationary types. This is the architecture of, this is an architecture, infrastructure architecture of wireless LAN. Here we have multiple number of BSSs, and there is a server or gateway or basic server, central station which is used to provide the services to access points, and these access points connecting the basic service sets with each other. And this whole infrastructure is known as infrastructure network. And this is the collection of BSSs is known as extended service set. When BSSs are connected, the stations within reach of one another can communicate without the use of an access point. However, communication between two stations in two different BSSs usually occurs via two access points. So obviously we will require a basics, we will require an access point, or if the stations are can directly communicate with each other, so they can do it. Okay, it is the speciality of extended service sets. So in next class we will discuss about the architecture wireless 802.11 framework and some other important points. Thank you very much.